just wanna feel this moment. Oh, oh, oh. I just wanna feel this moment.
Hi, this is Ethan, your host for Skyhawk News Spring Break Edition. In this episode, you'll get to see the Patriots and Loyalists debate, a story on Theater Club, and find out if Mrs. O'Malley is smarter than a fifth grader. Let's start today with school news. Thanks to everyone that made it out to our Barnes & Noble book night last night.
Hey Skyhawks, we're here at Barnes & Noble for our Barnes & Noble night, trying to raise money for our classrooms and our school library, and we are having a great time. Mr. Bond and Mrs. Lamelli both read really funny stories to the group, and Mrs. Liberman's class and Mrs. Ives' class both did a reader's theater about Dr. Seuss. Mrs. Gannon and my class did wonderful poetry tonight, and of course the theater club singing and dancing and doing their commercials. It was so much fun. We're raising a lot of money for our school, and it's going to be awesome for all of our classrooms and our library. I don't know about you, but I am sure glad that I came tonight.
Our class is here to perform a dramatic reading of Green Eggs and Ham.
That's Sam I am, that's Sam I am. I do not like that Sam I am.
Do you like green eggs and ham?
I do not like them, Sam I am. I do not like green eggs and ham.
I would not like them anywhere.
I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am.
Would you like them in a house? Would you like them with a mouse?
Not in a box, not with a fox.
Not, I would not eat them anywhere.
I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am.
What a fantastic event. Next week, we have a whole week out of school for spring break. After spring break, we have several events to look forward to. We have the Buy One, Get One Free Scholastic Book Fair, a Bear Reading Night, and a book swap. We'll keep you updated on these events. Let's get things kicked off with Jalen in the Blackfoot area with our first feature story. Jalen?
Thanks, Ethan. In honor of Dr. Seuss's birthday, the Beaches Restaurant came to serve green eggs and ham to the first graders. They all got Dr. Seuss hats and Dr. Seuss books.
What is my favorite
one? Here you go,
right? Right, buddy.
Just take out one ticket. There you go. Take them all out to me. All right.
Some first graders got to put on a reader's theater where they memorized the lines to the Green Eggs and Ham book.
I do not like them with a mouth. I do not like them here or there. I do not like them anywhere.
I do not like them in a box. I do not like them with a box. I do not like them here or there. I do not like them anywhere. I do not like Green Eggs and Ham. I do not like them, Sam I am.
What a bunch of lucky first graders. Now let's see a story from our awesome second grade with Tristan.
Awesome is right, Ethan. Hi, this is Tristan, and recently Ms. Moxley, second grade, did a play on an emperor who is trying to find a name for his cat. Let's take a look at the highlights.
We will be performing a play called The Emperor's Prized Possession. We hope you enjoy the show.
There once was an emperor.
I love my cat. I love my cat more than anything else in the whole wide world. I don't know what to call my cat.
She should have a very important sounding name.
The most powerful thing in the universe is the sky because it covers the whole wide world. From now on, I shall call my cat Sky. Cat, you are now Sky.
Look up above. There is a cloud covering the sky.
You are right. A cloud can cover the sky and hide it. Now on, you should call my cat Cloud.
You have made a terrible mistake. Look, the cat is chasing the mouse.
You are right. Clearly, my cat is the most powerful thing or animal in the whole wide world. From now on, I shall call my cat Cat.
And from that moment on, Cat was called Cat. And the cat said,
meow!
What was your favorite part about the play?
Making the costumes.
Why?
Because the designs were cool.
What character did you play?
I played as a cat.
What did you learn from the play?
That we all can work as a team and understand what we're doing.
Thank you.
Great story, Tristan. Looks like our second graders did a great job with memorizing their scripts. Kishi has a story on third grade. See if you can recognize one of our retired teachers in the story.
Thanks, Ethan. This is Kishi reporting with third grade news. Miss Dressdrop came to play some awesome Irish music in honor of St. Patrick's Day. Let's listen in.
Now heading to the Shoshone area where Rebecca is waiting.
Thanks, Ethan. This is Rebecca reporting from fifth grade where we have been learning about the causes of the American Revolution. We broke into teams and had a debate between the Patriots and the Loyalists.
Thomas Hutchinson is the royal governor of Massachusetts. He was born September 9, 1711. He went to Harvard College and was a very successful, great, and powerful man. Now give a big hand for Thomas Hutchinson.
Hello, my name is Thomas Hutchinson, and I'm the royal governor of the colony of Massachusetts.
Hi, I'm Bessie, a seamstress. Why are you the most hated man in the 13 colonies?
I disagree. I was just simply following the laws and trying to enforce order among the colonies.
Hello, fellow patriots and you loyalists. I am Benjamin Franklin, one of your founding fathers.
Hi, I am William A. Binker. How come you're a rebel and your son is a loyalist?
Because I let my son choose who he wants to be, just like I believe we can govern ourselves.
Give it up to the Anglican priest who loves God, Jonathan Boucher.
One reason we have the right to protect and govern you is because you silly Yankees don't know what is right and what's wrong. And if you disobey King George III, you disobey God.
Why do you think that we can't protect ourselves?
I believe that you can't protect yourselves because you have needed our help in former wars, one of which is the Indian and French War.
All we want is our own government and laws, so we don't have to go by your unintelligent rules. Will you bloodybacks ever learn that we don't need you to rule us, that we don't need your protection?
Hi, I'm Richard. I'm a local blacksmith. Why are you against independence?
Because the king created the colonies and you should listen to him.
Hello, my name is George and I am a local blacksmith. Why do you think you know what's best for us?
I know what's best because I was chosen to be royal governor of Virginia by the king himself. Hello, my fellow patriots and you doggone bloody backs. I think we deserve our freedom and should be able to elect our own government. I think taxes are ridiculous and that it's taxation without representation.
Senator Adams, why do you want freedom so much from the legal government?
Because we don't want to pay taxes to people who are 3,000 miles away from us.
Hello, I'm Mary and I sell fine British goods. Why do you think you should be able to elect your own government when we have great government right now?
Great government? Well, we think we should be able to elect our own government because we want to choose who represents us, not let you bloody bastards determine it. And I say, give me liberty or give me death!
Our theater club performances were spectacular. Let's get behind the scenes look with Desiree.
Thanks, Ethan. This is Desiree reporting. I'm here where the theater club put on two fabulous shows recently. I play a fairy in Slurping Beauty. I had the chance to interview some of our actors.
Haley, what's your favorite part in the theater club?
My favorite part of theater club is when you can act out and dress up. And my character is a snobby princess in Fairytale News.
What have you learned in theater club?
I've learned how to project my voice and how to memorize my lines.
What's your favorite part in theater club?
My favorite part is when I go up in front of the stage and I start saying that soup is not allowed anymore and I yell it.
Let's check out some of the highlights.
Fire-breathing dragons and elderly wizards, silly princesses and wild winter blizzards, all race against time, kind to losing shoes. These are the things on the Fairytale News.
Hello and good evening. I'm Sally's spokesperson, and this is a special edition of the Fairytale News at FNN, Fairytale News Network.
I suggest we head to the nearest store and get himself a life supply of mouthwash.
So the secret was simply mouthwash?
Yep. Mouthwash.
This year's winner for the annual house eating contest goes to our very own Gretel. And for her reward, a lifetime supply of all the candy, cookies, chocolates, and ice cream she can eat.
Oh no, I think I'm gonna toss my cookies.
Me too, let's get out of here.
Well, it's a typical day in Far, Far Away. We're having heavy gusts of wind coming from the eastern side of the little pig's house.
Oh woo! I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll pull your house down.
Get it today!
Something static, something frenetic.
cast a curse on the princess.
Xerxes, Xerxes, sizzle and zoop. Your man is going frightful and you'll slurp up your soup. Ha ha! It's delicious. I've never tasted anything so delicious.
Well, I believe I must be going at once.
Now announcing Jack the Giant Slayer.
Y'all want half some bean soup. Got a giant vat of it I need to use up. You wouldn't believe all the things you can do with beans. You can have bean soup, bean stew, bean salad, and bean gumbo.
Yum!
Then there's bean chili and bean casserole.
You've got to try the split pea soup. It's not great for sleeping on my back's killing me, but it's simply delicious, darling. Looks fantastic.
It'll put you in a good mood.
Because she ran away from the ball. Get it? She ran away from the ball. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo-hoo.
Don't cry. It's only a joke. Get it? Boo-hoo.
The two rather enjoyed one another's funny habits. They became the best of friends and lived happily ever after.
And the moral of the story is...
Just be yourself. Everyone gets a song. Everyone gets along. In this land, everywhere, it's a nice, comfy share. See the dwarves, see the thieves. Chase the wolf, chase your dreams. Come with me, take my hand, and we'll run. In a land where there's run free.
Battle of the Books is over now, and the final battles were quite exciting. For the fourth grade, the Encyclopinkias and the Readinators battled each other, with the Encyclopinkias being the final winners. I am now joined with the Encyclopinkias with some questions. What was your favorite part?
I liked battling against the other teams.
Thank you.
I liked reading and winning.
Thank you. How did you guys prepare?
I was very confident when I got home.
Thank you.
I got a good night's sleep.
The fifth grade final teams were the Midnight Wolves Return and the Bookworms. The final winning team was Midnight Wolves Return. Let's see some of the highlights.
In what book does someone hit their head really hard on a gym floor?
Longshot by Lupica.
Correct. Plus eight for the wow at the same time.
Oh, that's plus eight.
An Aid of War by
Davies.
Davies, yeah.
Correct. Fine. Borderlands Market.
There you go.
Is it Tialoa?
Yeah. When Tialoa came to visit.
By Albella.
And the mark down for the girl.
I'm here with sports news and the fun activities with the parachute. Let's check out what's been going on in our PE classes.
No, you weren't seeing double. This is Jalen here with my identical twin. We had an amazing Twin Day Spirit Day yesterday. Thanks to everyone that participated. And now, in honor of this month's character trait, a new episode of Mr. Responsible.
Hi, this is Mr. Responsible with a new music video. Hit it!
When there's trash on the floor, he will pick it up.
Ethan here with an all-new episode of Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? I'm here with Mrs. Lomelli to see if she is smarter than a fifth grader. Let's first find out our amazing prize from Jalen.
Mrs. Lomelli will be playing for her very own orange trail token. With this trail token, you are eligible to win amazing prizes. Just listen to Mr. Bond on Monday morning to see if you are the big winner. This trail token has a retail value of 1/20th of a cent.
But this prize will only be yours if you are smarter than a fifth grader. Back to you, Ethan.
All right, are you ready for your question?
I am.
Well, in fifth grade, we are learning all about the Revolutionary War and independence. So in that spirit, here's your question. Where was the Declaration of Independence signed?
Oh, that would be... Let's see, first of all, Declaration of Independence, and you're learning about Revolutionary War and independence. Wouldn't that be in Philadelphia?
Oh, I'm sorry, that's not what we were looking for. The correct answer is, it was signed on the bottom, see?
Once again, the fifth grade has worked together to thwart me and make me lose.
Now you've got to say it.
I have been fooled by the fifth graders. Is that what you want to hear?
No.
I'm not smarter than a fifth grader.
That's all the news for this week. This has been Ethan,
Desiree,
Jalen,
Kishi,
Tristan,
and Rebecca.
Reporting for Skyhawk News. Go Skyhawk! In this episode, you will see. Okay, we start that.
Hey. Hello, my fellow Patriots, and you doggone bloody bat.
1770 wouldn't have happened. They were innocent people.
Hi, I'm Richard. I'm a local blacksmith. I'm a local blacksmith.